Hi, I'm Lorne Cardinal, the honorary captain of the Dog River Howlers Rugby Club of Regina, Saskatchewan, Canada. On the surface, it looks like any other team sport. Non-stop action, teamwork, competitive, and hard hitting. But when you look a little closer, you soon learn that rugby is more than a game. It's a way of life. The Howlers is a rugby organization that does more than the usual rugby activities. For the Howlers, rugby builds bridges to connect people around the world. Through fundraising and charitable activities, the Howlers contribute to community development. What sets us apart is our philanthropy and unique philosophy.
A lot of people ask us, why would a rugby club get involved with charities? We think that it's really important that people know that we want to be valued members of the community and that we're training the young people that play rugby that really rugby can be more than a game, it's a way of life.
Let's hear from Carl Fix, the president of the club.
Sports is about learning life lessons. And I saw 40 years ago when I started playing the game, I learned life lessons. I saw life lessons that I learned, and now you want to pass on to kids that are coming up.
I want to thank all of you for kind of really getting the spirit of things. I hear there's more bags of stuff up here than you ever brought down here before, which says a lot about you. You understand what this is all about. So thank you very much.
Medellin, Colombia was the most recent stop for our under 18 youth team. This South American city of about 2.5 million people is notorious for its cocaine drug cartel and the violence that plagued their citizens for a generation. This rugby tour was an opportunity for our young athletes to test their abilities on the rugby pitch. It also challenged their values and beliefs as they immersed themselves into a culture of poverty, violence, and proactive community development. This Dog River entourage was about to discover why Howlers rugby is a way of life.
Watch me walk across that river, look the devil in the eye. Watch me catch a bolt of lightning, toss it clear across the sky. I know that might sound crazy, but just watch me. Watch me walk amongst the lions like I was one of them. Like fear is not an option, and this is not the end. I got my cards out on the table, and I'm all in. And just watch me.
So what was truly inspiring was when I got to go out and feed the homeless people. What these people are going through, I saw things that I would never see back home. Small kids living in a box, pretty much. It's so sad, yet they're so happy. It's crazy how grateful they are. There's about 14-year-old girls that were high. It's so sad. And they just don't know any better. That's how they've grown up, so.
I just think it's phenomenal what's been happening here with the Howlers, bringing donations down for the kids in the barrios. If you looked at the example of what goes on here, there'd be a lot less problems in the world if this model was used.
No, the Colombia tour is actually a very easy tour. They're very organized in Colombia, and they prepare, they help us with our hotels, everything. Of course, having Damon down there is a big, big factor. And so when we go down there, everything's kind of ready for us, and it's just a real positive experience.
One, two,
down, up!
Coaches from Canada and the Netherlands were recruited for the tour. With Rugby World Cup and Canadian national team experience, this coaching staff was prepared to give these young athletes a world-class experience.
It's up to you. I think of it as a kind of a buffet. I'm going to throw out some stuff. You try it. If you like it, awesome. If you have questions, please ask. But at the end of the day, all these little tools that I'm going to give you, all these things that I'm going to give you, are an opportunity for you to get better, okay?
Buenos dias.
Buenos dias, Camila.
Sasha.
I played rugby when I was a kid, and what I learned is there's a level of camaraderie in the game that you don't get in any other sport. There's a level of respect for the other players, and especially for the referees, you get in no other sport. And I try and tell that to both of my boys.
Okay, you start from that side.
We start playing that way, kickoff. Okay, have a good game.
Enjoy it.
Thank you. My idea now is first game to get into the game and put them under pressure right away. So if we kick to them, we can push and put them under pressure instead of receiving, and then maybe we have stress of I have to catch the ball. So I like to give the stress to the others. They have to attack, they have to protect the ball, so we push up right away and get into the game.
Thank you.
That's the plan.
I'm really impressed with the caliber of coaching
that's
been brought in.
Right.
And our daughters say that too.
Mm-hmm. They're having the time of their lives right now, learning rugby.
They're having the ball and they're learning.
Yeah, it's a small field, so square hips. Let's go forward. We can pull them side to side, but let's still go and attack and have the guys there quick to the breakdown and get the ball out of the breakdown quicker. Kickoff reception, how are we doing? Good. The one thing I'll say just over there is let's not forget our roles. So if you're that guy that's going in front of the ball.
Focus.
Let's get that guy in front of the ball. I think it was Moss in there. It came down, but it went in front. We didn't have a guy there. So let's just remember the rule there. Our kickoff, if they're catching the ball there and we're out of it, let's just go man and ball. Make the hit, okay?
What goes through your mind just before the game, usually?
It's observing who's on top of their game, who needs a little bit of extra support. Right now, it's an early start in this game. 8 o'clock, 8:30 in the morning, something we haven't been used to, but these are elite players and we need them on top of their game. So it's preparation. Who needs that little bit of extra help?
Right here. Matt, right! Right here. There we go.
Well done, boys. Well done.
Yeah, Matt.
How's it feel?
Tired.
Our first stop on the tour was at one of the neighborhoods, or barrios, of Medellin, La Cruz. This impoverished neighborhood clings to a mountainside just outside the city center. High population density, inadequate housing, and poverty did not stop this community from organizing several rugby teams. They greeted the Howlers with open arms and crushing tackles. A clinic and a couple of friendly matches provided a good warm-up for the Howlers as they prepared for their upcoming tournament. And as usual, the players distributed the much-needed rugby gear from Canada.
I think my most memorable moment was the first day we came here, and I saw the work that Damon and Jamie were doing in the barrios, and that this week we could help them a little bit with it.
To see these little kids that have been getting used soccer cleats or rugby cleats or a used ball or an old pair of shorts, they're just so thrilled, and it's been great for my boys to see that and really appreciate how much they've got and how some people don't have the things that they have, and they didn't get it before. I really think it's kind of clicked now.
One, two, three, oh!
So there's kids here playing rugby who would never have a chance to play if they didn't get some help to do it. But then how much work they got to put into doing it. just getting to the field for practices, climbing up those hills that are all over the place. The cost of the equipment is probably expensive for them. So I think she's got a better sense of that and how much better we have it in Canada. So I think that's part of the learning. And then the whole prospect of seeing how sport can impact people's lives in a way that she'd never thought about before.
Rugby is a very tough sport, right? You're tackling, you're out there, and it's you play like lions, right? And after the game, everyone shakes hands, everyone hugs, everyone's part of a family, and they all, I love that. This is different. Once the game's over, now it's about, it's something higher than everyone, right? It's something better than everyone, and that's what it is. It's more than just the game.
Well, I had to referee in Spanish and English, so it was a twist for me. I was really nervous. I'm so happy because I got a flag, a big one. I got a backpack, I got two t-shirts, and I'll try to exchange my hoodie. I'm so happy. It was amazing. I'm so happy.
Yeah, everything's going good. There's always hiccups. Wouldn't be life without it, so it's going good.
But that's where you got Leo, though.
Yeah, I think he's upstairs sleeping someplace. Where's Leo?
Where are we going?
Okay.
Do you know where we're going?
Another place.
Let's go.
No, because it's very difficult for the buses. It's
so how are we going to get up there?
I don't know what, because...
I think the La Sierra Barrio, the trip up there, you know, because that was as scary as it was at the time, like to walk through that barrio and see where, how those people live.
Walking up to La Sierra, doing that huge climb, felt like I was on a pilgrimage, exhausted, and I can imagine the kids only being more exhausted from the heat and practice earlier. And when we came up to the top of the field, finally got there and the music was playing and the other team was waiting for them and they all started cheering. I was so overwhelmed and I started crying. That's what I'll remember. I'm getting choked up right now. It was unbelievable.
La Sierra, another barrier and a new set of challenges. Some stiff competition, hot weather, high altitude, and a long hike up and down the mountain made for a true Colombian adventure.
Oh, I thought it was definitely a really, really hard-fought match. They're a great team to play against. They're really strong. I was very surprised. Coming from not a lot, they definitely do their best. They're really good. They're really good players.
Hey, Tony!
Mi nombre es Ana Lucía, soy era docente de la institución educativa Villa Tupac. De ahí comenzó el proyecto El Deporte No es Violencia y ahí nació el equipo de rugby de la Sierra. Y se vino trayendo en todo un proceso en compañía de Damon y ya hoy por hoy es un equipo conformado, fortalecido y ya trabaja con el Inter y ahí van para progresar en el país.
You know, sometimes I wish I wasn't always in front of the camera.
Well, you won't be when I get dark here.
Campeón y
Gives you an idea. I mean, it's like
their artwork is a reflection of the culture. And I knew an artist down there named Alvaro Daza, quite a well-known artist. He showed us some of his artwork. Actually, two parents bought some of his artwork. And then he took us to one of their famous art galleries that a lot of the Colombian art was in, and international art. So the kids, it was sport, it was art, it was culture, it was music, it was everything. And it's a total package.
I guess rugby is art because every game's a canvas and every play's a stroke of paint on that canvas.
The social world in the neighborhoods is amazing. Damon, since maybe 3 or 4 years ago, he's working with us in the development of in poor communities. For us, it's very important. Our guys, we are working with kids with a lot of social problems. So this experience is very important for them because they can see people from Canada with another opportunities. They can receive support or learn English or play against them is very important for them.
Watch me walk across that river with the devil in the eye. Watch me catch a bolt of lightning going clear across the sky. Now you might think I'm crazy, but just to watch me.
The story of Moravia is at one point in the 90s, it was labeled Time Magazine's most violent neighborhood in the world. Always been a fight with the Colombian government. Like I said, they left the war, they came here, they weren't welcomed by the city of Medellin. So at night, people would come, the government would come and try and tear down their houses. Okay, they would fight, the people would surround the Moro and they'd fight back. So and every time they'd go to another place, they'd hit the violence, right? Because they didn't have the community and they weren't able to handle the violence, so they'd always come back to their community. So for me, like I said, I could not believe the team these people had before we even saw rugby here. So they were fighting constantly for their home, basically. How did the transformation happen? The first thing they did was widen this river. So that's a free daycare. That's a cultural center. There's a brand new synthetic field down there. So they just started building social things and the neighborhood kind of tried to help itself. So that's the story. Most of them have now been moved off into different places. The neighborhood still has that image from outside people because it was so violent for so long.
I'd coached in the past, so that was a big part of my resume. And they asked me to bring some rugby balls down. So last minute got the Howlers to donate a bunch of balls and take them down there. And it was kind of cool because there was a little bit of a rugby vibe going down there. It was starting to, people had heard about it. So it was kind of good timing. I believe rugby gives a really good opportunity to have large groups of kids together. The nature of the sport, you're working together in group aspects. You're kind of protecting each other. And what I've seen in Moravia especially is the kids kind of flock to it as that kind of safety thing. Even if they're not playing, they'll come down to the field and they'll hang out and they become a family. So I think that's why it's more than a game in Moravia.
Bienvenidos al torneo Colombo Canadiense. Muchísimas gracias por venir.
Boys, let's add some intensity now, okay? Yeah. That was just a warm up. This is why we're out here, okay? Let's go. Let's finish this. Firing. Yeah, they're going to come back firing, so let's have some momentum. Let's go, as a team.
Always on three. One, two, three. Fires!
Let's go, boys.
Come on,
dude. Down. Good work. Well executed.
What do you think of that run? Was that run okay?
That was okay.
Coming down to a completely different continent, you know, is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for us. So just to take in all the culture and take in their way of life, I think, is huge. And she talks about it all the time.
Thanks, Mr. Carfix.
Por su visita. Por su visita a nuestra liga en diciembre del 2015.
For visiting our league in December 2015.
Y por enseñarnos que el rugby, más que un juego, es un estilo de vida.
And for teaching us that rugby is more than a game, it's a way of life.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
How did that feel, Carol?
What?
Okay.
Good.
It's nice.
Great day. Although, it would be nice to win both games, we won other ways, so it was great stuff. Great bunch of kids.
Oh, es un lindo torneo porque todos los juveniles están teniendo en su mayoría su primer partido internacional. Entonces para nosotros poder, gracias a los Howlers, brindarles oportunidad a los jóvenes de Colombia nos tiene felices.
Carl has introduced a concept that's more than a game, it's a way of life. And extending the capacity of that involvement. In rugby you go out, you play hard, you hit hard. But then afterwards, you meet with the people you were playing with. So you develop this relationship with opponents. If these kids bring this into their life in the future, they're going to impact an awful lot more than they would just by playing the game. And I think he has thrown that out there in a way that I think they will realize much later on in their lives, and it's going to make a much bigger impact, and I suspect he thinks it will.
Yeah, it's exciting to come down here and experience their culture and come out on top is even, like, it's more exciting, but it wasn't the whole point of the tournament. Exposing them to, like, the more knowledge of the game, and it's really unique here how rugby is it's a common language, and you don't have to, it's not a language barrier among anyone. Everyone knows it, and I was just thankful to spread what we know and what we have onto them to build up their program.
I would say it was definitely a life-changing experience. It's definitely made me a lot more grateful for what I have. Since we've been traveling into the barrios and all that stuff, and even just around our hotel, some of the things, like, it just makes me a lot more grateful for what I have and where I live.
This trip has been really pivotal for Maggie to really understand the enormity of the rugby family and how you can travel anywhere in the world, and if you're a rugby player, you have family. Police, Navidad, Hostel, and Open UCI.
top of my head, giving away the jerseys and the cleats and everything, bringing in the duffel bags full, lining them all out and seeing the rows of kids line up, just so excited to actually have a pair of cleats, like even look at a pair of cleats or have a new shirt to exchange with people. It's just, it's life-changing. And I'm gonna focus on more giving than receiving when I get home.
This Christmas is going to be very special because there's so many things that she has to share with other people. And I think that she will share it in such an incredible way that everybody will be touched by what she has to say about this experience. And they'll be changed because of it.
I'm having a hell of a time.
We've been working in some of the most violent neighborhoods of Medellin. We prepared ourselves to get in these neighborhoods, but these neighborhoods don't see rugby. They don't see foreigners very often. So I hope to give the Canadians a chance to see, to understand their privilege, to get into the third world, to see how people live, and to see people are happy with what they have here in Colombia, and maybe the Canadians can take that back home and use it in their life. For me, I'm measuring success right now in it sounds bad, but people alive. I mean, in these neighborhoods, you got people that they can get dropped into the gangs, they can trapped into the huffing and all those sort of drugs. So my success is seeing these kids graduating. Some of the kids are graduating in Colombia today. The kids are, they're pitchers, they're 19 years old, they're playing for the national team, they're going to university. So the success for me is just seeing that process and seeing it continue. So, yeah.
Anything else?
I'm good.
For over a decade, the Howlers have been sharing their Canadian values and sportsmanship and offering goodwill to communities around the world. The Dog River Howlers are ambassadors of the sport, playing the game they love. You see, rugby is more than a game. It's a way of life.
I am a new person, and when I start to play rugby, let me say thank you for all. Sincerely, always Carlos.
Well, at the Colombian tour afterwards, we asked each child, each player, and each parent to give us the highlight of their tour. Not one parent or one kid said anything about on-field activity.
My most memorable moment was waking up this morning and having my Facebook filled with friend requests from people from the local area here in Colombia, and knowing that even though I'm from a different country, I'll forever have ties to the people here in Colombia.
I'd just like to say how proud I am of our young Canadian athletes, how they conducted themselves on and off the field and interacted with the Colombian people, and I'm sure that they'll be an inspiration to the young Colombian rugby players and potential rugby players that they encountered.
The thing that impressed me the most about this trip was a group of young men and women that came here with no idea what to expect. And you went into these communities, you made a difference. You handed out things to kids that were less fortunate. You played and competed hard and then made friends after the games. You really are an impressive, exceptional bunch of young men and women. And here's a toast to the group. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you very much for you do for my country. Your social work for the special people is very nice. Real is very nice. The culture is very different. And thank you a lot. Thanks.
Maggie Banks,
Delaney Aikens,
McKenna Hawes,
Carol Mahoney,
Brianna Aikens,
Alexi Push,
Delaine Taylor,
Sue Fulnierda,
Sarah Alton,
Lexi Smith,
Taylor Hood,
Caitlin Ecker,
Leek Sless,
Gabby Schottel,
T
see our address. Adia Elliott.
Sarsia.
Natasha West.
Heather.
Linda.
Matt Fraser.
My name is Tommy.
Mawson Finley.
Elliot Johnson.
Corbin Bowen.
Dean Mason.
Stephen Weehan.
Thomas Rennie.
Kyle Goldstein.
Nicholas Taylor.
Tristan France.
Carson Sullivan.
Parker O'Sullivan.
Tim Norman.
Steven M.
Tony LeCart.
Senior.
Jack Taylor.
Leo Lane.
I got no time to waste to get to where I need to be. Coming back to the wall, I got nowhere to fall. I'm standing up tall, watch me walk across that river, look the devil in the eye.